106 people have joined till now.
Yes, sir. People are still joining.
Yeah, yeah.
So every day we are holding some webinar. Yesterday we did one webinar with the Special Secretary and Development Commissioner.
Okay. PhD chamber, sir? PhD?
We did it from FICCI yesterday.
Okay. Oh,
very nice. We did it from FICCI. PhD is going to hold it on Monday.
Okay, sir.
With the Secretary and Development Commissioner, MSME.
Very nice.
And
Responses are there?
Isme?
गवर्नमेंट है सब रिस्पॉन्सेस
गवर्नमेंट का रिस्पॉन्स है पर एक्चुअली क्या है गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग टू मच ऑफ टाइम गवर्नमेंट को सारी प्रॉब्लम्स पता है क्योंकि सारी इंडस्ट्रीज ने सारे चैम्बर्स ने भेज दिए अपनी प्रॉब्लम्स बट गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग लिटिल मोर टाइम इनफैक्ट दे शुड हैव डन इट फास्टर
गवर्नमेंट
वो कह रहे हैं अंडर कंसिडरेशन है पैकेज इज अंडर कंसिडरेशन डिमांड्स आर अंडर कंसिडरेशन By the time you know announcements are done and the package is announced, many of the units will get closed.
That
is a problem. Announced नहीं कर रहे हैं कि अभी तो close वैसे है. So they are taking their pretty more time to see that how situation pans out. That is also one of the reason, maybe.
This is the main reason. They want to have a reaction of the all the efforts, all the.
Otherwise, all bodies, lobbies have they already informed Hello? Government. No,
okay, sir, I think we should start the session, sir.
Start it?
Yeah, please.
Hello? We can start?
Yeah, yeah.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes, sir, we can start now.
So, heartiest welcome from the Resurgent India. This is our daily program, webinar. We are doing it every day. And this webinar we are doing for the NBFC. So we have a very prominent personality with us, like Sri Tripathi ji, who is very visionary. He was with the commercial banks about 39 years. And he worked in various departments, heading the various departments, even the corporate credit and other department also. And after his superannuation, so he joined as the MD and CEO with the Aadhar housing company. Under his leadership, so he come out a very noble scheme to give a housing finance to a downtrodden people who has low income. I think he given a new vision to this industry, and accordingly Aadhar housing is now considered to be one of the most important NBFC under the housing sectors. So his role is welcome. Even when I talking to his previous banker, everybody has praised for him, his vision, his action, and immediately he taking a decision. Sir, we welcome you on this
seminar. Thank you.
We are really welcome to you, and you have done a very excellent job. I'm thankful to you also for sparing your valuable time and giving a suggestion to us. So I am welcoming Sri Ashok Ji also, who is the CFO with Samunnati. He is doing the agriculture financing. This sector is very important role they are playing for the economic development of the rural masses. So he will tell us how these rural people, this company is helping. When I talk to these MD of these organizations, so I really wonder which bank cannot do it, how this NBFC, they are playing an important role. They are not even financing to the rural sector. They are also arranging some finance to the, you can say, who is holding the inventory of the crops or something like that. We will understand from him what type of difficulty he's facing and how he could manage the recovery aspect of the, you can say, under agriculture sector. I think the recovery is very, very high. So what are the reasons for that, we can understand from him. So we are with us Dr. Kumar, H.P. Kumar. He was with the National NSIC, National Small Industry Corporations. About 9 years he was there as a MD, CMD. Under his leadership, so he has taken about 156 branches in a different corner of the India. Beside that, the business he had developed, about 17,000 crore rupees, he had done it. I know Mr. Kumar from the very beginning. So he introduced very novel scheme for the corporations, for the MSB, SME. So he is providing a raw material to the SME sector and also taking a finished goods to providing a marketing to them. I think this is novel, so we deem it fit. Let Mr. Kumar tell how he managed the National Small Industry Corporations, and which we, I think we are not knowing before his joining. So how he managed even talking to the banker and having a one arrangement with the banker and signed the MOU, that whichever case are sponsored by the National Small Industry Corporation, they will give a finance. I think he's the best person, and he also got a President Award for the CRS. So he has a different award, he has got it. Beside that, even 35 countries, he have a MOU. So you welcome, sir, Kumar Saab also.
Thank you.
To you and how you have done it and what are the difficulty in this case. Now, major issue in this case is how the NBFC is failing in COVID-19. So one, I was reading one statement from the ex-governor of RBI and also some executives from IS cadre bureaucrats, where they have mentioned that India is capable to handle any type of crisis. This is a crisis management, they are expert in that. When I am going back in 1991 and 1992, when India was facing a balance payment problem, so how they have come out of the balance payment problem? Immediately at that time, there was a scam under a stock market. And how they have come out? They have come out because they have de-licensing. Even they have abolished all the industrial licenses. And immediately they have done import, but they have kept some ban. And they have come out very, very clear guidelines so that under the balance payment, they have come out. Even 97, 98, when there was a crisis, even at that time also, they were economic. You can say economics sanction was withheld by the USA, because we had tested something nuclear power. So nuclear power, but they have banned. Like at that time, the government has also come out very clear guidelines where they have helped the economy to grow it. Even they are ready to sell the, disinvest the PSU sectors. Then I am coming back to 2014, when there was again problem was there. So even Modi government, government of India, come out with the IBC Act and also come out with the, you can say, identify the bad debts of the banking sectors, and so that the balance sheet of the banking sector should be clean. Now again in 2018, you know, the ILFS and some NBFC, some housing finance company, also have some problem. In that aspect, government also come out with some partial guarantee scheme and pull buy up the assets of the NBFC. Now major problem, what we are here to together to discuss the way out of this problem of COVID-19, where we feel that economy is a shutdown. So it is also she feel that GDP, where the budget deficit in GDP, we are talking about 3.45%. But now IT Rindu says that it should be 6.2%. So you can understand when the deficit under the GDP will be going from 3.5% to 6.2%, then you can understand what is the position of our economy. And because the slowdown is there, there is no inflow of the cases. Banks have also in a problem. Even NBFC has a big problem in the sector. So how we can say to come out? So Reserve Bank has come out a circular on 27 March, where they have tell all the borrowers should be given moratorium of 3 months period, either in the installment and interest also. Even for a working capital limits, they are telling you readjust the working capital cycle. Accordingly, you can reduce the margin, you can have the working capital cycles, and 3 months no interest should be recovered from them. Only a 1st June it should be recovered. Mm-hmm. Now major aspect which we are here to discuss is the NBFC. They have already told the NBFC you defer for 3 months period. Like in major aspect is they have not given any guideline, any clarity whether the NBFC can also avail that deferment from the banking sector, because NBFC is facing a big problem. So it is some rating agencies has already come out that there will be a deficit of 1 lakh 75 lakhs crore rupees will be a deficit of the overdues. Because in that case, commercial papers, you're talking about the commercial paper, you're talking about the bonds, that will be also fallen due. What will happen? Even the NBFC, we have taken the deposits from the public, that may fall due also, that will also pay. And what is the solution for that? That clarity is required. So I have just summarized the position. They have also come out a scheme of, you can say, for the repro. Repro, you can have a 1 lakh crore rupees. So bank, Reserve Bank has kept separate fund under a repro. So bank can avail that facility. I understand from today, from a banker or by senior bankers, they're telling they only 50,000 crore rupees already pumped in the system. So bank are also giving this repro benefit to the NBFC, either in the shape of NCD or a loan also. They are providing this. Lekin that is only major issue is rating. If NBFC has a AAA rated or a AA rated, they can get the benefit. Otherwise, what about the A rated or a investment grade? That is also a bit problem with that. NBFC definitely going to feel a pinch because they will have not, they cannot recover or advance what they have given to the borrower. 3 months period is there. So how they will honor the commitment? This is a major issue of today's discussions. So now I invite Sri Tripathi ji. So this is a Tripathi sahab. This is a major issue these days because you also undergoing the same position. Because those NBFC, I think they are in 3x liquidity is there with the NBFC. It is also this that if within a 3 months period, that 3x liquidity may reduce to 1%. One time they will reduce it. Liquidity crunch will be there for NBFC. Where unless the Reserve Bank clarify the positions. So I just request Tripathi ji to give his thought view of NBFC overview and special in reference to this technology and also how the NBFC can use the technology and how they can redraft the technology people and how the liquidity crunch can be met out. Now request Tripathi sir, please give your views.
Thank you, Gupta ji. Thank you, Resurgent. And to my esteemed panelists, Mr. Kumar and Mr. Ashok, you have already given the outline for that. The COVID-19, actually, it is a very unprecedented time we are living in. Not only we, the entire globe is living in. And nobody knows when it is going to end. Nobody knows what is the remedy for it. Already the lockdown 21 days getting over and probably it is going to be further extended as the news has started coming out. And that has actually crippled the Indian economy because the Indian economy is largely the informal segment and the MSME segment, which is the backbone of the country. And a large number of people are working in the unorganized segment. Data shows 65% in urban working population and 90% rural working population is engaged in the informal segment activities and which is hard hit. This present crisis is actually much, much bigger than all earlier crises we have known to in past. All of us, even those who are in 90 years or 95 years, they might not have seen this time, which is full of uncertainty. The word UKA is absolutely applicable. VUCA is absolutely applicable. There is a volatility, there is a complexity, there is uncertainty, there is ambiguity in the environment. And so, we all are living in that. But my only one point that there is no need of getting into despair. We have to see what is happening. No need of getting reaction. You have just mentioned and given example one bureaucrat that Indian economy has been very resilient. Various shocks and it has responded. It has the ability to come out with the problem very soon. Unfortunately, right from the ILFS crisis from September 18 onwards, the NBFC sector has been under hammer. In fact, if I compare the Indian economy's slowdown started with the crisis of NBFC sector, post-September 18 crisis, because the liquidity is the oil, liquidity is the main thing. And liquidity was mainly squeezed. And whatever liquidity was available in system, it was available to the top rated NBFCs and HFCs, not to all. In fact, Ashok will contribute in that. Most of the smaller NBFCs, their contribution to the lending to the people at the bottom of pyramid who are contributing the nation's economy and earning their livelihood, that is more important. And they are the most hard hit because of liquidity. When this COVID problem has come, one part government did by announcing 1.7 lakh crore rupees package to the all those who were not getting the food because their job was lost. Their construction worker, village people, and so many people were there. The social aspect was taken care of by the government and top priority. And then Reserve Bank of India came with the announcement on 27th March, which we have just referred. The announcement, if you go to see, it was really most unprecedented in the, I think, probably history of the central bank. They gave the very great announcement. A lot of problems, a lot of apprehensions has come after that. The RBI tried to resolve The major issue is the liquidity, which always surfaces in these circumstances. When there is a such problem comes, the liquidity is the first thing which gets the back seat and which is most required for running the organization. So RBI tried to infuse through 1% CRR cut, then marginal standing facility, and then the long-term repo auction, 3.7 lakh, 4 lakh crore rupees. Who will get or who will not get? I will just come in 2 minutes' time. But enough liquidity, which is already available in the system, RBI topped up with more liquidity of 3.74 lakh crore rupees by announcement of 27th March. Second was the protection of assets. Whether it is an asset which we have lent, my own customers who are not able to pay because of the economic breakdown, because of economic disruption, the NBFC, which are the borrower of the banking system, we may also find a problem of paying to them, which the question has been raised by many, many participants were asking for this question. And the protection of asset was more important. For that, the RBI announced a 3 months moratorium. They thought this problem may go away, and 3 months is sufficient time to regenerate the cash and pay the installment and other things. Then the RBI immediately came to see that the banking and financial system is the backbone to take the country out of any crisis. And banking and financial system has been struggling because of large, huge NPA, because of the low capital base in the public sector bank. So RBI tried to defer the capital conservation buffer of 0.625 to September 2020, so that at least till that time, the public sector bank will not run for the capital requirement. That was also one of the major requirements which was there. Then the Reserve Bank of India also came immediately to the rescue of the borrower and building of the confidence and sentiment by reduction of the repo. Because what happens when the problem is so acute, the cost of borrowing has to be reduced and the customer should have more confidence. And that's why all those loans which are linked with the banking system with the repo, they got a huge reduction of 0.75% interest rate. And on the top of that, RBI reduced the reverse repo much steeper, so that banks should be dissuaded in keeping surplus money in the RBI, because reverse repo rate has been brought down drastically 3.65, so the lending should happen. The RBI tried to create a situation where the banking system will start lending to the needy sector instead of doing the lazy banking of keeping money with the Reserve Bank of India. That's why reverse repo has been steeply cut than the repo. Repo was cut by 75 basis point and reverse repo 90 basis point. And another important factor which you mentioned about the long-term repo action. Why this was announced? They thought that they tried to serve two purposes. One, by giving system liquidity to the banking system, and then made mandatory that 50% of primary issuances of the corporate and NBFC, HFC should be subscribed by the banking system for the investment grade company. Now here the question arises, because out of 1 lakh crore, 50,000 crore rupees was supposed to come to the system. But what happens is the always tendency of every lender to lend to the customer whom they find very safe. So unfortunately, RBI has not mentioned that the X percentage only should go to one entity. Now, suppose a bank could raise 10,000 crore out of the LTRO and they put entire money or AAA company, the all other HDFC and NBFCs will get deprived. Yeah. All other small companies will get deprived. So the purpose of RBI was to infuse liquidity, which probably may not happen if the RBI would have stipulated that not more than 10% can be given out of this money to one entity, so probably many entities could have got it. So fortunately, unfortunately, the decision taken by the RBI was in a very, very extraordinary spirit to support the economy, which has been badly impacted by the COVID-19. But nonetheless, there are some more clarification to come. Now, coming the first point, which I think you also mentioned, the 3 months moratorium. All NBFCs are required to give moratorium. The RBI said that there has not to be opt-in. Many people thought that we will take the consent of customer and they will give. They said, no, opt-in should not be there. If anybody opts out, you may not give him moratorium. Right. But by default, everybody has to be given. Now, if the NBFC has to extend the moratorium to all its customers, and they have to give it, they will not give moratorium, the large number of accounts will become NPA, and then the provision requirement will come. the capital requirement will be huge for the NBFC. Many NBFCs, small NBFCs are already struggling with the capital requirement. They will not be able to meet it. So probably giving up moratorium to customer to at least enable the customer to tide over the present 3 months problem, and probably thereafter the problem may be eased out. Today I was listening to Chairman SBI on some webinar you were telling that if the lockdown is further extended and the problem doesn't get resolved very soon, RBI may think of giving him more time also, which probably I think Kumar must be knowing that FICCI and AICI, they have requested for giving more than 3 months time. I don't know when it will come, but RBI and government both are alive with this problem. They cannot be oblivious with the what is happening in the economy. They will definitely come to the scheme. The only issue has come with the confusion in some guidelines. 27th March circular was very amply clear that banks, cooperative banks, small finance banks, NBFCs, all lending institutions, they will give moratorium. So that means we are, NBFC are the customer of the banks. So if we are giving moratorium, we are entitled to get moratorium from the banking system. There is no confusion in the guidelines, and the operating part of 27th March circular was absolutely clear. But unfortunately, thereafter, some clarification, I think IBS thought somewhere, and that had created a plethora of confusion in the entire media, all papers, all learned people, all big four auditors, everybody in the confusion. That even if account was in bucket 2, that is SMA 2 as of 1st March, the bucket movement will continue. So nobody is replying this question when the bucket movement has to continue, then why March, April, May moratorium? It means RBI intended that March, April, May installment moratorium has to be given. This period has to become zero period for the purpose of any bucket movement, and the logically, the status of account as on 1st March will be decided on 1st June, and from June onward, the bucket movement can be seen. That was the spirit of guidelines, but I, as we speak here, still RBI has to come to clarify all these confusion, which all learned people are busy in that.
So there, second, there is one point in that High Court of Delhi has come out.
I am coming to that point, sir Gupta ji. Yes, High Court of Delhi in Anant Raj case of Yes Bank,
yes,
they have discussed RBI circular in detail, yes, and they have given their verdict on the same point. They said the standstill position as of 1st March has to be maintained when the March, April, May EMI was not to be operational, were the question of bucket movement. But unfortunately, till RBI gives clarification, the decision of the banking system will be for the one case, not for all. So my many friend NBFC HFC is asking what to do. I said, don't worry. The system is not blind. System is always responsive. Have faith in system. Some confusion has become. Treat that your status of account as of 1st March will be taken till 31st May. Need not to worry. Now, well, coming to that.
Visionary. You are quite visionary. What do you expect from the government? What are your expectations?
When the first time on 29th March confusion came, I told my all friends NBFC people who talked to me, just wait. July 2008, when the problem came and RBI gave the restructuring guidelines effective from 1st July 2008, Gupta, you must be remembering, yes, till 30th June 2009, yes, they clearly mentioned the status of account as of 1st July 2008 will be a deciding factor.
So
RBI has always done the same thing in past. This time it's confusion is a confusion. Let us not panicky till RBI clearly comes out. Now, second point, whether NBFCs will get moratorium from the banking system or not, they have to get. It is completely illogical. Some banks have mentioned that they will not give. But yesterday I saw in TV, MD State Bank of India telling that he's considering to give moratorium. I am sure, because the plea was taken that LTRO is a substitute for the moratorium. LTRO, where is the guarantee that the small NBFC, which has given moratorium to his 2,000 customers, will be able to get from LTRO? If they guarantee that they will give liquidity, what is going to be impacted because of the non-getting of the cash flow because of non-recovery due to moratorium, it will be funded by banks, then there's no problem. So that will be a much difficult problem for the Reserve Bank or banking to manage to provide equal liquidity and assessment. They will give moratorium to all HFC and NBFC.
Sir, I 100% agree with you, because all the circular says all the loans of the bank, that include the NBFC also. Lekin I think some confusion is there unless the RBI come out with clarity.
I think Gupta ji, wait by 14th, 15th, when by the time the government has to come its mega package for the industry, for the MSME, for the informal segment. I think the government, by that time, it will be coordinatedly will come out, and then those guidelines will be quite elaborate.
I will come back to you. Now, Mr. Ashok is with us from Samunnati. He is the right person to tell about the rural economy, because they are morely concerned with the agriculture sector. Are the ruler artisans or even a ruler people, they are giving a finance. So when I've seen their financial positions, so their NPA level is minimum. So how he manage it, and what will be impact of this circular of RBI on 27 March, and how they want to come out of the problem? Because I feel that repro may, I think they may not get anything. So how they will manage the liquidity, that is more important, and what is their expectation from the government? Mr. Ashok ji.
Yeah. So, sir, good evening, and good evening all the participants, Mr. Tripathi, Mr. Gupta, and Mr. Kumar. Thank you for this opportunity. I represent a company called Samunnati Financial and Intermediation Mediation Services. So, I'll just brief about the company, what we are, how we do into rural, and how we are engaged with the farmer producer organizations and self-help groups and joint liability groups. So this company was formed in 2014, and 2016 we got a RBI license. After getting RBI license, we started with milk value chain. So there is a place called Tirunal Valley near Chennai, wherein we started giving loans to the farmers. Farmers use that money to buy the livestock, and the livestock, with that livestock, their milk production increased. And these loans were given, unsecured loans, to the rural farmers with a guarantee from Milk Federation. So on the basis of Milk Federation's guarantee, we could, while they used to settle the proceeds of the milk, so they used to deduct our money and give it back to us. So that way this company was started. Now every year we are growing at 100% CAGR into the rural parts of, although it was started in Tamil Nadu.
Ashok, I'm sorry, major issue is, how we will cope up with the circular of the Reserve Bank of India?
Coming to that, sir.
3 months period, and how your liquidity position will be improved for that? That is the point.
Yes. So this rural economy, especially, we have given loans to SHGs and JLGs. RBI circular dated 27th of March talks about giving moratorium to our customers. So what we have done, our customers who have taken EMI loans, so those customers, we are giving the moratorium on the basis of their opting in or opting out. So customers who have opted out for this one, we are not giving moratorium. However, major customers into this SHG and JLG, which are into the last mile, those are the farmers, especially women farmers, there we are given the moratorium. However, the sad part is that, as Mr. Tripathi said, that getting moratorium on our loans, it is getting difficult, because banks are asking whether you have a negative cash flow, whether you are, if moratorium is given now, how are you going to service that in the month of June? And in our case, recently we have started getting loans from the domestic banks and private sector banks. Our major loans are from the international NCDs, like impact investors like FMO, Triados, and those. So there, this circular is not applicable. So 27 March circular, which is applicable, we are on one side giving to the customers. However, other side, we are not able to get from the bank. So there is a dilemma. Like what you said, sir, that LTRO may release approximately 3 lakh crores or something, but that is not available to the smaller NBFCs like us. We are the NBFC with a BBB+ rating. In one notch, in 1 year, we got a double notch upgrade. But BBB+ is not an investable grade for getting into CP market, commercial papers or other bonds market. So getting moratorium from the banks is all the more necessary. As you said, Yes Bank case and Delhi High Court decision, all that is all right. But RBI is yet to come up with a clarification that whether moratorium is applicable to all the NBFCs. across, or it is on the need base, or it is the discretion powers of the banks?
A major issue is what you are expecting your liquidity position, because you are not being allowed by the bank to have a moratorium. How you will meeting your liquidity, and so, how you are going to honor your commitment?
Yes.
With the depositor or with the, you can say, with the bank.
Yeah. So what we have done a cash planning, at least next 5 to 6 months of repayment obligations, our operational expenses, salaries and all should be taken care of. To that extent, we have beefed up our reserves. We have got loans from the other NBFCs. I'll be happy to tell you that two NBFCs and one bank has given us a loan in this lockdown situation also. We did documentation online. We signed, scanned the copies and sent to them, and they honored and they gave us a loan. But banks are, it is becoming difficult. Private sector banks are yet, we are able to talk to them. But PSU banks, they are taking a long time because their meetings are not happening. And virtual meetings are taking place or not taking place, that we are not aware.
My only point is, you will be comfortable for your liquidity positions.
Or yes, sir. So with the reserve we are having, we are comfortable for next 6 months of our obligations.
With your reserve, you can maintain.
Yes,
and we are. Another point is, for a short term or a medium term, very cost you are feeling it, it will come down by the repo or something like that.
So
by the bank, they will try to reduce the cost.
There are 2-3 avenues wherein which will help us bring down the cost, because as Tripathi sir mentioned, repo rates, reverse repo rates, LTRO and MSF facility, all that liquidity is going to be in the market. Banks are flooded with the money. Only thing, this lockdown has to reopen. They have to go back. They have to work on the proposals. So interest rates are going to come down. Like SBI is the first one to start with reducing interest rates by 75 basis points.
You feel that commercial banks are going to reduce the rate of interest for the NBFC also. And it will be impacting on the borrower also for you? For
yes, sir.
Borrower, so also you will reduce the rate of interest or something?
Yes. So commercial banks, when they reduce the rate,
for your borrower,
to be back on to the customers.
For charging interest.
Yeah. So commercial banks, when they reduce the rates, when the borrowing...
What do you expect from the government?
So, sir, government, there are 2-3 things which are important and they should be doing it. First is that there should be a clear mandate given by RBI to the banks that moratorium should be offered to the NBFCs, and not only NBFCs with AAA, AA or AA+. NBFCs like BBB+ also are investable grade. And we have done our rating from CRISIL-like company. So, we should be given a credit and moratorium also.
You can tell us which banks during the lockdown period given you a loan, given you some limits or a credit facility.
Yes, sir. I'll be. Yeah. I don't mind referring, because the DBS Bank, we have signed a debt origination agreement with them. So they have given us a short-term loan of some amount. And it was credited to our account on 31st of March.
Thank you very much. I am just coming to Mr. HP.
Sorry.
Sir, you want to say something else? So now I am coming to HP Kumar, Dr. HP Kumar. During his period of National Small Industry Corporation, he had done a lot of work to give a raw material to the SME sector and giving the, marketing. Sir, now once you are given a raw material, they will not honor the position of the payment. So for 3 months, moratorium is there. How you feel that the National Small Industry Corporations, how they can help the SME sector, whether they are also ready to give a 3-month moratorium period, whether they should consider that aspect for the SME sector? Mr. Kumar.
Thank you, Mr. Gupta, for inviting me here to deliberate on this issue. In fact, the role of NBFCs, that is the issue that is being discussed. The role of NBFCs is very substantial post-COVID-19. In fact, NBFCs are one of the major players in the financial markets in the country. Over the last couple of years, we have seen that the banks have been very shy in extending fresh credit, as also helping the existing customers with regard to the enhancement of credit limits because of the obvious problems of NPS. So what we have seen is the liquidity has improved with the banking system. The credit offtake has been very negligible, very small, less than 10%. And now, over and above that, the Reserve Bank of India has increased additional liquidity of 3.75 lakh crore, as Mr. Tripathi also mentioned. So where is this liquidity going? I mean, what are the banks doing keeping this liquidity with them instead of helping the industry and the sector? So NBFCs have a very great role to play in between, because NBFCs, half of the MSME sector particularly and other trade and industry depends on NBFCs in the country. And large number of NBFCs have been doing a wonderful job. In fact, you see the success rate of NBFCs in the country, whether it is in consumer finance, industrial finance, factoring or housing finance or microfinance. All those NBFCs have been doing a very great job. Forget about few NBFCs which have been exceptions and proven to be irregular and created a bad name, like ILFS and all those companies, for the sector. So by and large, NBFCs have been doing a yeoman service and a wonderful job. And MSME sector particularly and the trade and industry looks forward to the MSME's contribution post-COVID-19. Having said that, how will the NBFCs be facilitated to do this? Here comes the role of RBI and the banking sector. The banks have to be liberal in providing not only the liquidity support, but also, resolving this problem of 3 months, moratorium, which is being discussed and has become a bigger issue than, in fact, the actual problem of financing the trade and industry and the sector. So that is one part of the entire discussion. Second thing is NBFCs have to be empowered. NBFCs have to be facilitated by way of liquidity. Now, there are plenty of models which RBI can work out and the banks can work out. It is not that the banks have to reinvent the wheel. Banks have already been financing NBFCs. They only have to extend their helping hand and provide the required liquidity to the NBFCs. First thing. Second thing, the reduction in the repo rate. Over the last 2 years, the RBI has already done 175 basis points, which substantially has not been passed on. Now, this time also 75 basis point reduction has been done in the repo rate. We expect that all these will be passed on to the industry and the commerce and the MSMEs through NBFCs also, because ultimately cost of finance for NBFCs, cost of finance for industry and the users of finance, whether it is from banks or the NBFCs, is similar. It should be the same. If banks are providing concessions, they should also provide concessional interest to the NBFCs so that it can be passed on to the sector. Third issue which I would like to discuss, I will come to the NSIC model later, because I'm more concerned with the MSME sector as such in the country, because NBFCs have a greater role to play for the assistance to the MSMEs post-COVID-19. So security is another issue. The models have to be worked out, new models have to be worked out, where the government guarantee by way of credit guarantee fund trust of micro and small enterprises can be liberalized. It is already there, but then the conditions are so tight that most of the NBFCs are not able to avail that credit guarantee. We are requesting the government that that also should be liberalized. Even individual cases should be covered instead of bulk guaranteeing, bulk portfolio, bulk exposure to be guaranteed by the credit guarantee fund, and removing some of the restrictions. Fourth is even insurance of the credit portfolio of the NBFCs should be expanded. It is there, of course, but then again, it is subject to a lot of restrictions. Because if you really want to improve the exposure of the NBFCs to the country, you have to have these safeguards and the cover available to them. Well, I was looking at SIDBI's report just a few days back, where they said that there is an exposure of about 25.2 lakh crore to the MSME sector. I'm talking of MSME sector, which is, of course, 99% of the entire country's industrial sector, as the Honorable Finance Minister mentioned in the budget speech. Now, when 99% are MSMEs, and the RBI has provided assistance to NBFCs, and NBFCs are providing assistance to the MSMEs, they have to provide all those concessions and all those benefits which are expected by the MSMEs. Since NBFCs have extended a lot of credit, there was one requirement which we mentioned to RBI, that all the dispensation through NBFCs to the MSME sector should be classified under the priority sector credit. No, it used to be there prior to 2012, but then ultimately after 2012, RBI withdrew this classification, and after a lot of persuasion with the government and RBI, they restated last year only to a limited extent of last to last year up to 20 lakhs per customer. So there is a need to in fact reconsider that provision also and classify the funding through RBI, through NBFCs, to the entire MSME sector under the...
One point is there, NSIC was doing the rating and now I think they have stopped it. Special reason for that?
Yeah, let me come to NSIC. NSIC has a very good model, as you said, that raw material support is provided. Now, post-COVID-19, apart from money and liquidity, raw material also will become availability of raw material also will become a very important issue. And NSIC is engaged in providing raw material on credit to the entire country, to the MSME sector. Now, how do they recover that money? Because you said without security, it become a problem. See, they provide raw material and then they procure the material, finished goods, and supply help in supplying to the government. So that is how it is automatically, there is a self-liquidation of that raw material credit by realizing the money from the...
My point was entirely different.
Yeah.
For 3 month moratorium, whether the SME sector, what you suggest from the NSIC, they can give to the this SME, because their problem will be there. They cannot honor their commitment. Even if you have taken the guarantee from the SME sector, they will invoke the guarantee by the NSIC, then they will in problem. Whether that can, they can also provide 3 month moratorium to the SME.
They will provide. I am not looking after NSIC as of now, but then my hunch is and my recommendation is that the moratorium of 3 months should be provided.
And why they have stopped a rating for that?
Rating, in fact, the performance and credit rating which NSIC started, in fact, was funded by the Government of India, in fact, to start a culture of rating among the MSMEs. Now, that rating scheme ran for about 10 years. And in 10 years...
I think it was going very well.
Yeah, it was doing very well.
Now they have stopped it. What are the reasons for that?
Actually, it was funded by the Government of India to the extent of 75% of the rating fee.
Yes, sir.
And if your rating fee was 1 lakh rupees, 75,000 rupees was being paid by the Government of India through the budget. And gradually, government wanted that now, since the culture has spread and MSMEs have become aware of their own. And RBI has also brought in Basel norms, whereby the bank credit rating has become compulsory. So gradually, they withdrew the funding and the subsidy. And that is how the rating came to it. I mean, the NSIC rating came to it. At the negligible level. It is still there, but the only thing is government is not funding it. And MSMEs have to pay for themselves.
Tomorrow there are some questions were there. So yes. Just I am stopping you here. So I am talking about the Tripathi sir. Tripathi sir, there is a question for you from some audience, because you feel that some small NBFC, whether the big NBFC under this liquidity problem can take over it? It is possible?
No. Takeover is always possible when two parties agrees. Right. There is nobody can take over anybody unless the company which want to sell itself. Or it has to be a bailout package, which like a DHFL RBI announced. So normally it doesn't happen. In case of these things, when a small NBFC can themselves try to sell to a bigger NBFCs, but what the I think audience wants to know, in the present scenario of liquidity crisis, what will happen? In a very dynamic economy, it is always there. Some will merge in someone else, somebody will buy somebody else, somebody will fail, somebody will survive. Good olden days, the idea was that nobody should fail. The financial sector was allowed to fail. But in a growing economy, you cannot stop it. But I think after October 18, this crisis is going on. Many NBFCs are finding it difficult to survive or sail through. There may be a possibility. I also come across a couple of requests that why can't you buy us? So this always happens. Some promoter opened an NBFC and today after 2 years of a long journey of liquidity crisis, they are not able to survive, they don't get the capital, then what is the way out? They will sell themselves to somebody else.
Very nice, very nice. Sir, another question is whether lowering rate of interest will not having the, you can say they can take a further advance from the bank sector in the lockdown, after lockdown period, and how it is going to affect the economy? Somebody asked this question.
I agree, Guptaji, it is very important question. If you see, after October 18, the all banks increased the rate of their existing loan from 75 to 125 basis point without increasing their cost. Right, all NBFC you talk, you leave aside top parentage NBFCs, most the NBFCs face the brunt of the banking system. In the name of the risk, they increase the lending rate. Yes. But from the June 2019, when the RBI started cutting repo and the bank started cutting their MCLR, the same rate cut was not passed on.
Yes,
today, most of the bank will not reduce 75 basis point repo cut in MCLR, but 25 to 20 basis point most of the banks are reducing. But I still am not sure that this transmission will be made to NBFC. They are transmitting the rate to their own customer, but they are not passing on this benefit to the NBFC. Logically, if you see, risk on an individual customer of a bank is more than the risk on an institutional NBFC. But somehow the concept in last 1.5 years has gone in such a very disruptive manner that bank feel NBFC, HFCs are more riskier than an individual customer. Today, if you take, they are lending at 7.5% to their own home loan borrower. But when they have to give a loan to the HFC, they may give a AAA HFC loan at 7.5%. Yes. But all other HFCs are able to get loan at 8.759%. Now, if you see, if I am getting loan from the bank at 8.75%, how I will be able to lend at even less than 11% because my cost of operation has to be added. The problem comes when I am lending to a smaller segment of the borrower, like informal segment of borrower. Okay. I am not able to cut the rate because my cost of fund is not lower now. So the request to Reserve Bank of India is that whatever the MCR reduction happened from June 2019 till now, that should be passed on the rate. Instead of increasing the spread, they should pass on it to the NBFCs also so that they can give ultimate loan to the lower rate.
Sir, another question is, at present, what is the coverage of the insurance for a housing loan or something? So whether it loss having the NBFC are covered by the insurance companies.
The question is whether
the insurance and the borrower, it can be friendly.
You see, there are two things. In case of housing loan, the most of the housing finance company, they get the borrower's loan insured to his life. That is called a monthly reducing term assurance. Like if borrower has taken a 50 lakh rupees loan, as the loan is repaid, his liability gets reduced. If the borrower unfortunately dies in between, the insurance company will pay. So as a protection part, we definitely get the insurance of our loan with the life of the borrower. That is one part. Health insurance, other insurance are the secondary part. As regard NBFC is concerned, NBFC for their own customers, they must be getting insurance to some extent. But in the home, that insurance is already covered and NBFC can also get it. Now, if you are asking the insurance part of the borrower's loan amount, the risk if you are talking.
Yes, yes.
You see, IMGC, India Mortgage Guarantee Corporation.
Sorry, sir, it's been stuck down. Oh, I think time. Hello?
Sound is not coming?
Now it come. Yes, sir.
There are different forms of insurance are available. It is not available. They can provide their lender also to the insurance. They can get the insurance from insurance company. And most of the, I think, NBFC, they are getting the term insurance of the borrower done. So that in case of any eventuality, they can recover that.
Sir, death is okay. Other health is okay. Lekin my point is whether the NBFC can cover their loan portfolio by the insurance companies.
No.
Okay. That is important. In fact, that is the point which I was also trying to.
That is I am telling you, that is not available. But in case of which Kumar Sahab has mentioned, there are two type of guarantees are available, not insurance. Abhi credit insurance swaps are not largely available. What happens in case of low income housing, the government of India has made a scheme of credit guarantee scheme for low housing. Similarly, there is a credit guarantee fund just for small loans, small scale loans, that is available from the banking system or the lender. In that case, if the loan get defaulted, some 75%, 60%, 80%, they can get from the Government of India a scheme that is called Credit Guarantee Fund Trust for Small Loans and Credit Guarantee Fund Trust for Low Income Housing from the National Housing Bank, from the Ministry of Housing. That is available. But in case of small loan micro industries, it is largely utilized by the banking system. But in case of housing, it is least utilized because the terms are very so rigorous that we are not able to take benefit from the government.
But this LIC housing or something, they are getting some coverage of their loan portfolio?
No. Though there are only guarantee available. One is from the India Mortgage Guarantee Corporation.
Yes,
they charge 1%, 7.75% premium. They provide guarantee.
Yes.
There is no credit insurance available as on date. The talks are going on, but it should be available. Only one insurance company, Credit India Mortgage Guarantee Corporation, is available.
I'd like to add something about the insurance, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
See, as you said, trade credit or credit insurance is not possible in India, but there are talks wherein there are some Singapore-based companies that are talking about giving a credit insurance through GIC, not directly. Secondly, other two liability insurance covers are possible, that is fidelity insurance for the employee infidelity. And secondly, professional indemnity policy. Recently, we got a quote, being an NBFC, getting quotes for both these insurances are very difficult, but we could get it for fidelity and professional indemnity for covering fraud risk.
But that is Ashok is the fraud. He is asking about the
major point. What
I talking about credit risk.
In case of a business failure, whether the insurance is giving a coverage for that, that is a major issue. Just like receivable or things, they are not getting it. So just like insurance of the inventory, they are giving insurance. If some theft is there, some loss is there, something there is covered. Whether is business loss. Is coverage there for the NBFC? You are taking some coverage for that, or there is available or not?
Gupta, I told you, I think Kumar Sahib will add to it. Credit guarantee fund trust, which is available, I think up to 5 crore rupees, that insurance, that guarantee cover is available. If
Hello? Again, some problem is there.
Yeah, let me add here.
Rajkumar sir.
In fact, this credit guarantee fund trust of micro and small enterprises, which is being given by the Government of India with the help of SIDBI, that is available to NBFCs also. But the problem that is existing is that most of the NBFCs are not able to utilize this fund, this guarantee, because of the restrictive clauses and the restrictive conditions, as Mr. Tripathi also rightly mentioned. Even in housing case, housing loans also, the credit guarantee is available from the, a special agency which has been set up by the Government of India. But most of the housing finance companies are also not able to utilize that guarantee. So problem is the terms and conditions.
Hey, Kumar sir, whether it is available, business insurance is available.
For micro and small enterprises, for NBFCs funding the micro and small enterprises, credit guarantee is available from the Credit Guarantee Fund Trust for micro and small
companies.
CGTMSE. Is available.
Okay. Another point was there is cash credit limits. If the drawing power is not there, whether it will be converted into WCTL. For that, my submission is the bank has been allowed to lower down the margin to meet the drawing power. That they have a Reserve Bank already allowed. There is no question of converting into a WCTL. Somebody asked like this. So reply is that they can lower down the margin by the banks and they can reset this working capital cycle also to enhance the limits also. That is already allowed by the Reserve Bank of India. Sir, another Tripathi sir, one point is with me regarding your this software. in software, whether some modification is required to assess your working your limits, because all NBFC are having a software, their system is developed. So whether that system requires some changes in view of this lockdown or some financial position or something like that. What is your reaction on that? Tripathi ji? Or Kumar sahab, you can tell.
Yeah, I can.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
Yes, you want me to answer that question? Hello, are you able to hear me?
Yeah, we are, sir, we are. Please go ahead.
Hello. Hello.
Hello, yes, Mr. Gupta, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir, please go ahead. Please go ahead. We are able to hear you.
Actually, the issue raised by you is a little technical, that whether the software adjustment will have to be made. Surely it will have to be made because of the, you know, extension of the repayment schedule and restructuring of the repayment schedule, because ultimately with the moratorium, three installments or interest will have to be shifted. And maybe the banks decide or the financing institution decide, whether it is NBFC or bank, to revise the repayment schedule in entirety, or maybe provide 3 months extension in the original repayment schedule, or maybe fix some installments for the payment of interest. So all these things will require a little bit of, you know, tweaking in the software, and which will have to be done by the individual NBFCs, you know, based on whatever software they are using. It has to be done.
And sir, apart from that, with the tweaking of the repayment schedule, restructuring and all, NPA calculation also, because RBI says that NPAs has to be directly coming out of the system. So on the basis of this tweaking of restructuring, NPA schedules also has to be worked out. So definitely there is a change required in the softwares. Absolutely. And which most of the NBFCs have taken up. We also have done it internally.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Mr. Tripathi seems to have been muted. If somebody can open his mic. Mr. Tripathi, you are muted.
Hello, hello. Hello, Tripathi sir.
Yeah.
Hi, sir. What you are telling, sir? You have changed the software.
Now it's okay.
Gupta ji, when you have to provide moratorium, you have to make necessary changes in the your software. You have to see that the moratorium is given effect, and the NPA, this moratorium impact should not create any NPA. The bucket movement should start from June. I have already done it in my company.
Assessment I am asking for. Assessment of the limits. You want a change in something, some another feature you should add in that your software or not?
My point you is see, that. You see, many NBFCs are talking that now the assessment model has to undergo change post COVID-19.
Yes, sir.
You see, it means till now the NBFCs were not assessing the customer based on their cash flow. My point is that unless you decide, keep certain sector out of your policy, there is no requirement of changing anything. What I mean to say, if you are thinking that X sectors are vulnerable, we have to not fund them, you have to put in negative list. All those things you can do. Because assessment of cash flow has to be based on the business, which is as present now, not the past. Historically, you will not take. When you go for the new loan to the after COVID-19, you have to assess a customer afresh based on the same requirement. Unless you decide to increase the margin or certain things you are picking more risk covers, all those things company may decide. Some companies may tighten, some companies may continue. It depends on the company's own risk assessment of the customer going forward.
Right, sir. Very nicely, sir, you touched all points. I am thankful to you. All of the, any other point from your side? To Kumar sahab, you want to say something? Kumar sahab.
Well, I would say that Resurgent India should keep doing such programs. It was a very good program today.
We are doing, sir, daily 2 or 3 program also. Because I think we are sending you the link for that. Every day we are doing something.
Okay.
Today we also done morning some other program. And tomorrow, even Sunday, we are doing it. every day Resurgent India is doing all such things with your good wishes. I think the participants also crossed 144 crossed it today. And there is a good response from the sectors.
It went up to 190 at one point of time.
I think
Mr. 190.
143.
No, it went up to 190 at one point of time. Mr. Ashok,
I think you are also in a rural economy, you are playing very important role.
Yes, sir.
Any suggestion from your side, because the rural masses, the rural people or a farmer will definitely be hit.
Because
the inflows of some will be a problem. How you are helping these people after the COVID?
Sir, this after the COVID, what we have done, we 75% of our operations comes under essential commodities. Which deals with commodities, pulses, grains, maize, wheat and all. So we are providing funding. We are not stopped disbursement fully. And apart from that, we are also giving loans to this small help, self-help groups and JLG group ladies, because these are the ones who are into the last mile. They are into rural. Although we get some guarantees, but these loans are continuing.
How your sir, recovery is very, very good is when we are comparing with the bank.
Yes. Right. How so as Mr. Tripathi said, we take a call on the cash flow of the transaction. What we do, sir, cash flows for the borrower. So escrowing and deduction at source, that gives us a lot of comfort. So that's how we are able to have 98% repayment efficiency, sir.
Ye group housing mein bhi aap kuch karte ho? Group scheme mein kuch, you are doing something? Ye small help group kya hote hain wo? Small help group for women enterprise or something like that. You are giving some finance to them also?
Yes, we do. For self help group, in fact, self help group are the member of ladies who they come into a group of 15 or 20 coming forward. One of the lady member becomes the secretary, other one becomes the treasurer, and they manage the group. So these groups are given the loans on the basis of some middleman guarantee. So middleman is, we say B2B2C. So middle B is nothing but a not-for-profit organization or the trust. We take a guarantee from these companies, and on the basis of that guarantee, we give these loans. And sir, I am happy to tell you that these rural ladies, they pay sharply on time. So repayment efficiency is 100%. They say whatever loans you are giving, if you even double it, we should be able to pay it in time.
Very nice. Very. Sir, Tripathi, sir, last question from your side.
Yeah,
what do you suggest the audience? We, all the people, I think some NBFC people are there, some SME sector are there, some entrepreneurs are there. I think you are a quite visionary man. So what do you suggest that how they should manage their liquidity? At this, because the factory is closed, they are not doing anything, inflow is not there, and they have to pay fixed expenses. You will salary, they will have to pay. Some other expenses, fixed in nature, they will have to pay. What is your suggestion to them, SME sector or other people, even a self-employed people, how the liquidity they should manage?
There was a question I was seeing on the screen. Akash Gupta was asking whether the salary cut is solution for NBFC. I think that is, before I come on liquidity, that is one of the very, very, very widely asked question among the all CEOs, small employees, everybody, whether salary should be cut. One thing is there, when you are in a difficult time, you have to manage your expenses so well, because that is the only thing that you can, that is in your hand. The collection from the customer, liquidity from the bank, these are all challenging issues. But the expenses you can cut, but there's a limitation of cutting expenses. We do not know whether this problem will continue a month or problem will continue for 6 months. My point, I use the word UKA, we are in uncertain time, and it is not today. Every 3, 4, 5 years, some virus will come and it's been hit. It does not mean that we'll stop living. So we will stop innovating, we will stop doing work. My advice to each one of my participants here, be always optimistic. I don't say you should be over optimistic. You should always live with the situation, try to solve the problem, but don't think these uncertainties will not come. We have to manage. Cutting salary immediately today, everybody, 21 days, organization was closed. And everybody is thinking that heaven has fallen. And at least wait for 2-3 months, see that probably in 2-3 months, situation may get improved. Like I am just giving an example, informal segment. If a chai wala is there, a small restaurant is there, sabji wala is there, the moment market is open, they will become active in their job. There are only a few SMEs which take some time to get revived. The normal small SMEs, they start working immediately. Government will definitely come with the package, as Kumar has mentioned. If the government comes with a huge package to support SMEs, now the baby steps will not help. Now government has to come with a huge package for SMEs to revive them at least for 1 year, and because so that they can come up. One point, what I look from the government, they gave 10% partial guarantee scheme for the sale of portfolio to the banking system. Instead of that, if they provide 10% guarantee to the banking system to give loan to SMEs, probably the banking system will love to give the loan. But I think it is the high time the government, instead of infusing the cash, government is short with the fiscal money. The government is already having fiscal constraint. Instead of that, if government give banks, I will give you 10% guarantee. Need-based assessment you do, all double B and above NBFCs, and give them requirement of their loan. They will survive. So to my message to all friends, try to be in touch with your lenders. Something will come. Gloom and doom never stays long. Human beings are very innovative. They will be able to come out of that. Do not see too much of WhatsApp.
One question is there. What are the 5 MSC sector which NBFC will be focusing to give you fund? 5 and you can say SME sector. Which sector you are interested to give a funding for that? Either you can say in manufacturing sector, or a service sector, or any other sector, which you feel that they will be survive.
You see, Guptaji, today the challenges to the aviation, they are out of reach of MSME. Challenges to the hospitality sector, small hotels giving loan is not a problem. Big hotels is challenged, the economy is revives. Textile, big textile, no need not to be given, but small textile you can give loan. So MSMEs are serving to the small people. You see who are their customer. If their customer are big one and they are riskier, you avoid them. Otherwise,
I think SME sector who are in manufacturing or service sector, I think they should not
sir, be all consumer demand were there. That is not going to stop. Giving loan to that sector who serves the consumer's requirement, there is no problem.
So, Professor, another point somebody raised, this is SME 1 or SME 2, special mention account, where the Reserve Bank has left to give any type of concession. Whether it is a fair on the part of the Reserve Bank of India or something like that, to leave these people, because they are not a NPA account as on 1st March, and they have left untouched. So even banker are not ready to give any relief to the people, except the High Court judgment is there. You cannot change the classifications. So what is your reaction on that?
Guptaji, yes, this will come with a positive solution in the next 4 or 5 days. I am very optimistic.
Yes, I am also feeling
this has been an illogical interpretation, which High Court had very logically put forth. And I am sure that if the good sense will prevail to the entire system, this will come out. You cannot kill a person who is on ventilator. You can kill a person who is dead. Are somebody is on oxygen, you cannot say dead. The SMA 1 is not a dead person. There are some persons who have tendency to remain in SMA 1. You can't change the Indian psyche.
You cannot change it. I agree with you, sir. Sir, another point is credit deviations. In respect of the balance sheet will be hit. For this financial year, the balance sheet will be hit. All the ratio, other thing will not be, you can say, for SME sector will not be there. Whether the government should or Reserve Bank should think over it, for the assessment of the limits, not on the basis of the balance sheet, and see what is the financial strength of the firm. What is your reaction on that, sir?
Guptaji, we should not expect any decision from the government or RBI for one company. They will come in the sector as a whole, number one. Number two, March 20 balance sheet. If you logically ask me, The entire problem had come beyond 21st March. By 21st March, 90% business was already done. Aye, aye.
So, sir, दिल की बात सर आपने कह दिया. मैं कहने वाला था.
तो मार्च दिल की बात कह दिया. मार्च 20. We should worry about 2021, not 2020.
I said percent agree. Sir, another issue is what are the moratorium in bond? I think there is no moratorium on the bonds. Even nobody has given any moratorium on the bonds.
I was reading
of CP or something like that. I think Reserve Bank has not come out in that.
No, this is not in the purview of RBI. SEBI has, Gupta, SEBI has already discussed, and those which are unlisted bonds, SEBI has been kind enough to agree on that. For remaining bonds which are in listed company, mutual fund industry has been requesting SEBI. SEBI is in touch with RBI. Today, paper was telling that it is an active consideration of SEBI because the bond payment has also come from same cash flow from which term loan cash flow has to come. So probably SEBI is actually working to see this thing. Non-listed companies bond, they have already allowed. But the listed bond, I think they have to come out. I am sure that something will come forward that also, otherwise mutual fund industry will bleed further.
Sir, we are really thankful to Apna Tripathi sahab like a visionary and Mr. Kumar and Mr. Ashok. I think it was a very fruitful discussion today regarding this RBI circular and how NBFC come out the things. So point is, I think our discussion summarized position is like that. So we expect that Reserve Bank of India and banker will come out to help the NBFC for their rehabilitations, for their not facing any liquidity problem. I think that we should wait for a few days. And because these federations of these all NBFCs, so I've seen that they have already represented to Finance Ministry on 30th March. I think something will come out. We are really thankful to all the panelists, all the visionary, and Tripathi sahab, I have taken much time from you. And you have clarified the position of all the participants very well. And I am thankful to other Mr. Ashok ji, who is the expert in the rural sectors and on the rural economy. I think he is managing very well of this NBFC. And lastly, I am thankful to the HP, Dr. HP Kumar, who has given his values of his suggestions also to us. We are thankful to you. So with this word, I close this. If anything you want to tell Mr. Tripathi ji, and Mr. Kumar, and Mr. Ashok, so you are welcome. Lastly, if say something, so you are welcome, Tripathi sir.
Thank you, Gupta ji. Thank you, Ashok. Thank you, Kumar sahab. And thank you all participants. Thank you all participants. It is the time to think of survival. Revival will follow and growth will follow thereafter. Be optimistic. Be happy. Nothing is permanent in the life. You are only person who can create things the way you like. That is what I want.
I am much delighted, Tripathi sahab, to listen to you, your viewpoint. I am thankful to you. So, I'm thankful to all the party.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Always feel thankful
to all the people. Thank you, all the participants.
Thank you, sir.
For listening and raising the questions. Thank you all.
Thank you.
We'll leave this.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.